F-35 beast mode. How America's stealth jet becomes a bomb truck. The F-35, known for its stealth and precision, can switch to beast mode, vastly increasing its firepower. In stealth mode, the F-35 carries just 5,700 pounds of internal weapons to minimize its radar cross-section. However, once air superiority is secured, the jet can deploy external hardpoints, boosting its payload to 22,000 pounds. This transformation allows the F-35 to carry up to 14 NRAMs and 6 2,000-pound JDM bombs, though at the cost of halving its operational range. Beast mode ensures the F-35's versatility, allowing it to dominate in both initial stealth operations and prolonged, high-intensity conflicts. F-35 Beast Mode, transforming stealth into sheer firepower. The F-35 is typically perceived as a graceful and refined fighter, created with advanced features emphasizing concealment and surgical precision. The common perception is grounded in truth. Indeed, the F-35 is a fifth-generation stealth fighter, built to house software that enhances network connectivity and data sharing. But the common perception discredits the F-35 for its versatility and for its ability to roll up its sleeves. Remember, the F-35 is a multi-role fighter, and when prompted, can be reconfigured as a straightforward, knuckle-dragging, bomb carrier. The reconfiguration is known as Beast Mode. All-out flight. Designed with stealth technology, the F-35 is adept at entering contested airspace, avoiding detection, and engaging enemy targets, all before air superiority is established. Really, the F-35 is designed expressly to initially establish air superiority. Due to its focus on stealth capabilities, the F-35 had to make sacrifices in terms of its weapons carrying capacity. To enhance its stealth capabilities, the F-35 aircraft uses an internal weapon bay instead of external hardpoints, which can greatly up the radar cross-section of the plane. Even though the internal weapons bay increases the stealth of the aircraft, the storage capacity within the fuselage is restricted. F-35 stealth or carry. Enter beast mode. In stealth mode, when the F-35 carries weapons internally, the jet can handle just 5,700 pounds of ordnance. That breaks down to either 4 AI and 120 AMRAAM missiles for air-to-air missions, or alternatively, for hybrid missions, 2 AMRAAMs paired with 2 GBU-31 JDM bombs. That's not very much firepower, but the concession is worthwhile to gain stealth benefits. However, once air superiority is established, once an enemy loses its anti-air systems such as air defense missiles and guns, sensors, interceptor aircraft, stealth mode becomes less relevant. And when stealth loses its relevance, the F-35 can enter beast mode and use its external hardpoints to maximize its firepower. In beast mode, the F-35 can handle 4 times more ordnance than when operating in stealth mode. Using the external hardpoints plus the internal weapons bay, the F-35 can carry 22,000 pounds of ordnance. That breaks down to 14 AMRAAMs and 2 AI-9X Sidewinder missiles for air-to-air missiles. Or, for hybrid missions, the jet can be outfitted with 2 AMRAAMs, 2 Sidewinders, and 6 JDM 2,000-pound bombs. Indeed, the boost in firepower is significant, although, in beast mode, the F-35's operational range is cut in half, to just 1,400 kilometers. Something may feel counterintuitive about using the F-35, a 5th-generation jet/supercomputer, as a simple bomb truck, a role that clunkier Cold War era aircraft like the F-16 or B-52 are entirely equipped to handle. Yet, when you consider that the F-35 program cost taxpayers $1.7 trillion, the notion of using the jet just to secure air superiority in the opening salvo of a conflict becomes offensive. And for the US, which has a tendency to invade countries with rudimentary air defense systems, and then stick around for multi-decade occupations, the F-35 needs to be able to do more than just sneak around and wipe out air defense systems in the first few days of conflict.